All right, this is the basic Goucho foundation. This is for the 66 Super Shasta. You probably have different paneling and so forth. I put that little door there so that the plumbing could be accessed. There's handles in there that need to be turned once in a while. And the 66 Super Shasta has these little side compartments. They're only an inch thick, and they put these metal runners on top for easy sliding of the Goucho when you fold it out into a bed. What those 1 inch thick panels are for, compartments anyway, is it does a dual purpose. It gives you support for the edges of the bed when you pull it out this way, but it also hides the plumbing and electrical that runs through to the back here where the fresh water tank is, as you see. Okay, so you start there. You have to start with, if you look back in my videos when I was building this trailer, you'll see that I put a ledger back here. All right, and that ledger is right there. That ledger is to support for the couch part of the Goucho bed and the bed itself. All right, so you want a ledger all the way around like that. And what you have to do is determine that height according to this part here. All right, I've rebuilt and repaneled all this. So we are ready to build now, okay? You have to make sure that that's all level and straight with each other first. So the first thing you want to determine is how much support you want. I like to put as much support in as I possibly can, and yet not overdo it. And I'm going with 1 foot on center for the slats that will go across here, okay, like that. So I've already marked it out in the back, and it won't be completely even on this end. On the street side, it'll be a little short, maybe 10 inches, but you don't want anything on the edges because the slide out needs to be on the edges. So we start a foot in, and we will go ahead and make 6 slats. And those 6 slots will supply the support for the couch part of this project. Alright, I'm going to use 1.5-inch nails to put these in to begin with, and then we'll put a screw in each one also. And to get them pretty much square, I'll use this guy. I'll use my framing square to get them square like that. Okay, I want to make sure we're in the middle. So these are, you know, it doesn't have to be exact, but basically these are going to be 1 foot on center. Okay? You want them square so they don't bind up when you roll and close the thing. And we're going to use our Harbor Freight $20 brad nailer and get it loaded up here properly to nail with. We'll put a nail in each side on both ends. way. More hose in here. Same here. Some reason that guy didn't want to go all the way. Might be a knot under there. There. Okay, and we're just going to do that all the way down. Alright, so there is our basic foundation for the seat part. And now what we're going to do is build the slide out part, which will look pretty much the same but with a piece of plywood on it. And then the plywood that's left over will go over the top of this. One will slide over the other. It's really pretty simple. Alright, here's my drawing, basically. My terrible art type stuff here. I'm not a very good artist. But there's my drawing, and you can see that our slide out part is going to be 82 3/8 inches wide, okay? And that's the basic frame without the supports in the middle. The supports in the middle will be as follows. There, so basically, it's going to be the same as what you just saw, except these slats will be in between the slats on the basic base frame of the seat. Alright, so doing a little figuring here, you know, our slats are 25 inches. Your dimensions are going to be different, so you want to figure this out for yourself. Don't use my dimensions, your trailer may be different. So we got 25 inches here, and if we cut out a 25 inch piece of plywood to cover the slide out, which is what this is the slide out, okay? Of course, we already have our other part up here, which is basically our ledger all the way across the back and the two sides. And of course, we have the front, which is the face of the couch. We're going to be putting, alright, we've already got our support like this in the middle. What we're going to be building next here is the slide out. Get this all in here, a little out of proportion. yeah, and then all we have here is a ledger. Same over here. Okay. So what we're building now is this bottom part, the slide out, okay? If we take 25 inches out of a sheet of plywood, which we're using 3/8, that's going to leave us with a 23 inch piece minus an eighth, which an eighth of an inch slop you don't care about, that you want a little bit of slop anyway, because no trailer is perfectly square. So that leaves us with 23 inches. Let me get my pens separated here. I don't make threes very well. A lot of people think my threes are sevens or twos. So 23 inches is left, minus an eighth, for the thickness of the blade. And I've already cut all these guys. Okay, there's seven of those, one on each end, and then the middle ones. And of course, these will also be 1 foot on center, which will put them directly in between the ones we've already installed in the back part of the bed. All right, and so we're going to go ahead and cut the sheet almost in half to 25 inches. And then we're going to place these slats here. We're going to place those on there and glue them and screw them. Do you remember my DeVille build? What was the old saying back then? What are we going to do, folks? We're going to glue it and screw it. Only in this case, we're going to glue them and screw them. It's been a long time since I've used that term. Alright, so that's the basic design and the basic measurements for this trailer, the 66 Super Shasta. We'll go ahead and get building this slide out now. And you're going to see, this is actually pretty simple. These slats. Well, actually, let me use just one of them. Well, actually, they actually stick out that much to sit on this face, okay? That face is the same height as that ledger. And this thing will slide in and make a couch and then slide out to make a bed. As it slides out, the back of the cushion comes down and takes up the rest of the bed. So you really want this part to be a little deeper this way than this part, because this part's the back, and the back is usually shorter than the part you sit on. So that's the way we're gonna build it. I think Shasta does things a little bit different. It's kind of crappier. Well, I know they do because I have the other one sitting over here. But this is much stronger and beefier. Alrighty? Is everybody thoroughly confused yet? Alright, I'm going to cut on, I'm right-handed, so I'm cutting on this side of the line. So, we're going to mark this 25 inches. I'm cutting from the back side. The other side of the plywood is much nicer. It's sanded on that side. Alright, so we're going to mark 25 inches. Mark it four places. I've got the plywood up on some 2x4s for cutting. The remainder will then go in the back to sit on. Safety glasses. So nobody yells at me. Besides, I just want to be safe. Now we're going to set the depth of our blade here. Make sure all our safety stuff is undone here. We're going to set the depth of our blade to just beyond the thickness of the plywood. You know, like maybe an eighth of an inch at max. There we go. Get to it. Now we have to cut the length, which is 82 3/8. Now I've made that measurement and left it a little bit short to make for easy sliding between the walls and without damaging the walls. So let's go ahead and take a measurement. Double check my measurement one more time just to make sure. I don't want to have to buy another sheet of plywood. This sheet of plywood was $30. Okay, I double checked my measurement. It is 82 3/8. So, we'll cut that end off. For safety reasons, it's always good to let the saw blade stop before you move the blade. Also, it keeps your work clean because you might jiggle it on the way up and hurt the edge of the plywood if it's still running. But it's mostly a safety thing. All right, that should be it. Now we're going to put this up on the table and we're going to glue and screw our slats on here, our finish slats. So it's on the slider. Now I went inside and measured, because there's, you know, a quarter, half of an inch difference or something, but I want these in the center of the other slats. So except for the end one, we know that goes on the end. And then the next one goes at actually 19 inches. So we're going to put a mark there. Next one goes 12 inches from there. Then we go 12 on center. And like I keep saying, your measurements may be different. Probably will be. Due to the different measurements of trailers. Come on here. All right, so now we're going to go 12 on center, basically. So the first one will be 12. The next one will be 23 and a quarter instead of 24. The next one will be 35 and a quarter instead of 36. And the next one will be 48. All right, so we're going to do the same thing. Let's get these out of the way. We do the same thing on the other edge so I can center them all. This is on center, okay? The center of the slats. Same way that you speak when you're talking about framing. So first one is at 19. So we're just going to glue these and put them on here, and we'll put some weight on it, and we'll let the glue dry for an hour during lunch. It's just about lunchtime. It's an hour past lunchtime, actually. And then we'll come out, flip this thing over, and put screws in there just to make sure. Because remember, the weight's going to be going this way, and without the screws, the glue could separate. You just, between the screws and the glue, it'll hold just fine. Okay, now I just did something wrong. So I may delete that last segment, but if I don't, if I leave it in, then you get to see my mistakes. So that I make it. I almost made a mistake. I had to think about it. Whenever you're doing a layout, especially if it's an upside down layout, you want to really think about what you're doing. Because what I want to accomplish is, I want this side, this is the factory edge here. The cut part of the plywood is here. I want that towards the center of the bed. I want the factory edge out here because there's going to be a face on it like this, okay? There's gonna be one of these. It'll actually be like that, okay? It'll be there all the way down. And I might make it decorative, I might round the edges, I don't know yet. But if we do the measurements I just told you, then this whole thing flips over, all these are wrong. So I have to start my measurement from the other end, not from this end, because it's all going to be flipped over when it's done. So you want the 19 inches down here, and then a foot apart, not up here. So you see that? See the mistake I almost made? So let's refigure this, okay? And what I will do is use a colored pen so I don't mix up my measurements. All right, so we'll start this all over again with 19 inches here, because when we flip it over, this will be on the left, which is where I measured from. So 19 inches, and then we'll go a foot. On center, or basically a foot, but we'll use the measurements that I got here. So the first one is 12. And then 48. So in this case, I almost made a mistake, so you don't have to. Yeah, I'm going to leave that all in. Love it. Okay, there they are spaced out. the way they're supposed to be. Hopefully, because I really don't want to mess this up. And I'll look one more time. So we have, yeah. Alrighty, so what we're gonna do, get your clamps out. You're gonna need clamps. I'll start with one in the middle so you can just see it. All I do is I flip it over to the left like this, keeping everything stationary where it's supposed to be. All right. Glue's cold because it's not real warm in here. Get some glue on there. And then we flip it back over so that we're in the center. And we want it flush on this edge. We don't care if it sticks out there a little bit. Make sure you're in the center and flush right here. That's very important. All right. Oops, I moved it because I leaned on it. There we go. I want to make sure we're centered here. We're not, okay. So you can move it around to check and see if you're centered. That way it'll kind of move the glue around too. Okay. All right, there she is, all glued up, and we'll let that sit over lunchtime. Maybe an extra hour beyond that. So it gives it 2 hours of pre-drying time, and then we'll turn it over and we'll screw it using flathead wood screws. You could have used, I could have used panel adhesive, construction glue, like I could use Type Bond. You've seen me use that before for this type of stuff. You could use liquid nails. I could have used that. I just didn't have any out here. I don't think I have any at all really right now, and so I do have Gorilla wood glue, which will work just fine. It's just maybe a little more expensive, maybe not, I don't know. Anyway, this is what I used. So let's let this all dry up, and when we come back we'll flip it over and put some screws in it, and then we'll go ahead and put the face on it. The face frame is going to go in the front here, and that will stick up, which in this case down, but it'll be up. That keeps the, it not only gives stiffness, but it also keeps the mattress or the cushion from, you know, sticking out too far. And that will be 3/4 inch thick. It'll be the same stuff that we just used here. All right, I've got the back piece of bed platform, 3/8 inch plywood. I wanted to use quarter, but I couldn't get any. It's sanded on one side, the other side, because right now it's tilted up out of the way, so you can see what I've done with my slats. I did add, right here, see if we're focusing, it looks like we are. I added a slat on each end near the end, because the slider has a piece that slips in here. But I added one of those on each end just for extra support on the ends, because I noticed when I had it in here before that it, you know, sort of like, you know, drooped a little bit. As far as this back piece was concerned, it would droop a little bit. Didn't want that. I wanted support there, so I added these little guys on the ends, which are just out of the way of the pieces that slide here on the slider. You'll also notice, get this down, I put a couple finger holes in here so it's easy to grab that. You only have to lift this up just a little bit to slide the slider under there, because the slider does go under that, so you only have to lift it up just a little bit. And of course, in order to do that, you have to reach under the cushion to grab this. Lift it up a bit. This is after you already put the cushion up. Now, I don't have the cushions. Those are going to be made later. We have no cushions for this trailer at all. and no seats for the front. So those will be made after I'm finished with the trailer. She'll have her own upholsterer do that. But yeah, you reach under the cushion, pull this up a bit, and then slide the slider underneath there. And you do the opposite to pull it out. You just pull the slider out and push this to the back, because it may drag a little bit with the slider. It shouldn't really, but if it does, you just push this back out of the way. It drops down level with the slider wood, and which you'll see in a minute here. And that's how it works. So we've got a really strong platform here, and it houses all the plumbing, the pump, and the fresh water tank. All right, now what I'm gonna do is make the face frame for the front of this slider. And I'm also gonna round the top of the back here, this corner, because this slides under the back panel, you know, the other panel. And you want to make it easy, slide easily. So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, round this. And I'm going to round the corners and sand the sides a bit to make them smooth, just so everything slides nice and easy. Not bad for a $79 tool from Harbor Freight, eh? Now I'm going to do that same thing, I think, to the middle part of the plywood on the slider. And like I say, that's so that we can slip this under the stationary board. Plywood is so thin that the guide doesn't want to go very deep, so we're going to have to sand this round. Okay, now what I've done is I've gone ahead and where every slat is under here, there's slats under here, remember, I've marked it on the faceboard, and I'm pre-drilling two holes for the screws that are going to hold it in. So I've got the end slats and then all the ones in between. And then before I screw this all up together, I'm going to paint this board fundamental white. Now here again, for production purposes, saving time in other words, you make all your marks first, put your pencil away, and then drill all your holes. Remember what I teach, just like with shellac, always paint in one direction and finish your last stroke of paint towards the wet paint.
So it doesn't matter which way you go, to make your last stroke into the wet paint. And that way you won't have little paint ridges. Like that, see? Well, right away I have a hair, and I was just paid $7.50 for this brush. I was told it wouldn't lose hairs. And I'm only painting this to protect the wood. White, you would think, is kind of a wrong color for, it might get dirty and stuff. And you're right, fingerprints, dirty fingerprints would make this dirty. But the owner, who's going to be having the seats made, and any other upholstery, I think it's just the seats, is gonna have this covered with vinyl or Naugahyde to match the bunks, because the bunks, their face frame, are covered with a beige upholstery, like vinyl, Naugahyde. So, that's gonna happen to this thing too. I'm building it so it can be removed easily, covered, and then put back on easily. And that'll happen when she does all her upholstery. That's pretty much the final coat. Now I'm gonna go clean this very expensive brush. And $7.50 for a brush. I think that's kind of expensive. Only lost one hair though, right in the beginning. Right, now I'm just using my last screws that I talked about before. They look like they have a washer mounted to them. Putting those in, and I'm pre-drilling the holes. Just because I don't want the ends of my slats to... don't want those to split. Now the only thing that will be left to do here, after I do my test fit and everything, is to screw down, put some screws flush down into the slats. So we don't need many of those, we just want enough to make sure that with a lot of weight and everything that that glue doesn't separate. Oop, how'd that happen? Further, I'm going to go ahead and make some marks on the plywood here where the slats are. So 15 and a half here, let's see. So 15 and a half here. This is for the screws on in the top. 28 and a quarter. Just put little arrows here. Now, what a lot of people have trouble with, and it's, they don't just have that trouble in trailers, they have it anywhere where they have to put panels, large sheets of anything, inside of a small room. And the whole idea is to, you know, to bring it in like this, where you have a high side and a low side, so it's easy to maneuver, and then, and get it where you want it, and then drop it. So, I've got cameras, a camera inside the trailer and this one, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. I already know, because I've, you have to have a plan, because you don't want to be scratching up the inside of your interior when you're doing this. And I found that the best way for me to get in is to actually get in like this, holding this thing up and down until I get it in this way, and then I can start tilting it and moving it around in there to get it in there.
So you'll see what I'm talking about. I gotta get the other camera going. Alright, so I'm going like this. Okay. Let's see. Is this right? I think it is. No, I can't remember. I turn the camera on, I get all stupid. Alright. Like this. That's what it is. Gotta be careful. Try not to be banging on things. Okay. Now, we're gonna get one end high and one end low. About the only thing I hit was the lineup. And then we can just place one end where it goes, drop the other end in. Oops. Something's. Okay. There we go. I got a pretty tight fit here. Don't really need to make it that tight. Let me show you what it looks like now. There you go. So there's the bed in all its glory. And hang on a second and I'll show you how this all works. I'll do this from a couple of different views. So basically, you just reach back here and pull the back sheet up, slide it like that. This is the easiest way, and then slide the whole thing closed. And that's really all there is to it. That's about the easiest way, I think, that you could possibly do something like that. Let me put the camera over here. And I'll show you how you open it. Basically, same thing. Just pull this open like that, slide that back like that, and you're there. And it's pretty solid, but it could use a leg right here, and I have an idea for that. So here again, the ease with which this system works. Just pull that up a little bit. You don't have to pull it all the way. And then just push this closed. Nothing could be easier. Pretty simple.